Lumix GH6 will make Micro Four Thirds live again. Let me tell you some of my few ideas about the criticizing that I've saw online about Micro Four Thirds being dead, about the fact that Micro Four Thirds image quality, it is not sufficient and we always have to go to a full frame camera to have that good image quality. And I want to talk about what is image quality, about Micro Four Thirds, and why I think that Micro Four Thirds should live on and we really should invest in that system. Video where I will not enter in too much technical details about GH6, but it is more a reaction to a known YouTuber that criticized Micro Four Thirds after testing this camera, saying that image quality for him from a Micro Four system, it is dead and there is no chance for him to come back to Micro Four Thirds. And this is why I want to address these issues, because the discussion started from GH6 that it is such a beautiful and great camera for videography and photography, but the image quality, and let me show you what I have to say. Hi there, my name is Tudor Matescu and on this channel I like to talk about photography gear, tips and tricks, so please be sure to subscribe for more content like this. I'm an avid Fujifilm user, Micro Four Thirds user and full frame camera user. I like all the camera systems out there and I don't feel the need to criticize a system by comparing that system to another system. Every system has his weakest and his strongest points. An APS-C system or a full frame system or a Micro Four Thirds system can't resolve all the photography or videography problems of a user. Some users need portability, some users need good image quality, and this image quality it is very debatable, and other users need a system that is able to do them all, to be a jack of all trades. So from my point of view, an APS-C camera can be called a jack of all trades, but again, you can't do with an APS-C camera what you can do with a Micro Four Thirds camera or what you can do with a full frame camera. Check my video regarding if you should switch to Fujifilm if you are an Olympus user. So I'm a big fan of Micro Four Thirds camera and I keep buying Micro Four Thirds lenses because I like the good glass that Olympus brings to the market. This is the 12-45mm from Olympus and I've recently bought the 20mm f1.4 from Olympus again, and please be sure to check my review regarding the 20mm f1.4 lens that I think it is a beautiful lens. I think it is the best 40mm lens that it is out there and in a Four Thirds format. I really love that lens, and on a full frame system and on a Fujifilm system, I really don't have the chance to get that image that 20mm f1.4 it is offering me. So let's get to the subject regarding the GH6. So the GH6 was launched and the well-known YouTuber told that it is the best Micro Four Thirds camera, but for him Micro Four Thirds it is dead, because indifferently of what Micro Four Thirds will do, and that camera has all the whistle and bells that you can imagine for photography and for videography, that camera it is dead for him because of the Micro Four Thirds image quality. And in that video he was showing a video with Micro Four Thirds quality filming at ISO 12 and 800 and the images were very clean, but the image quality was not like on Lumix S5. And I want to talk about that a little. I think the image quality of a Micro Four Thirds system, it is a image quality that must be understood. It's not a bad image quality. You really don't have to judge the image quality by looking at pixel level and by looking at contrast level and by looking at details. Our eyes doesn't see in the real world details like the newer modern camera are seeing. This is why film users are liking film so much. This is why film users are liking to use an old camera. That camera, that images are organically looking. So what is good image quality? What is the definition of good image quality? I think it is very personal, and I think it is something that has to do with your own education. I love paintings, impressionist paintings, but some painters are doing paintings that are looking like a photograph. I don't like that paintings. I know that is hard work in there, maybe harder than an impressionist painting, but especially I like paintings that aren't clear, where the details are blending with each other, where colors are blending, where there is a game between light and shadow. I like these kinds of paintings. And I feel that Micro Four Thirds, it is offering me in some situation that feeling. It is offering me that images, that mirroring images of the world. I feel some special quality from the Micro Four Thirds system. And yes, I really know that sensor, it is limited. But again, I think you can bypass the limiting of that sensor, how I've said in my video regarding Fujifilm versus Olympus, when you are using good pro glass. And when you are using good lenses with the newer sensor and with all the whistles and bells of GH6, a 25 megapixel sensor, and I really think that this sensor, it is very well suited, because yes, we need a little more resolution to have the chance to crop in, to have the chance to export the image at a lower resolution but with lesser noise. I really feel that that new sensor, it will be a game changer. And when they will put that new sensor on a Lumix GX9 and on a Lumix G95, G100, I don't know how they've called it, then I don't know, we can talk about the future of the Micro Four Thirds camera. Again, the images that you get from a Micro Four Thirds camera, that you get from a GH5, I really like those images. Lots of people, when the Lumix S5 or Sony cameras came out, they went to full frame. I can understand the need for good AF, but when I'm looking at their images, at their video images, okay, at first they are looking better. But when I'm looking at the GH5 images, at that filmish look, at that, I don't know, balanced, mirroring looking image, it looks in a special way. And I think this special way of a Micro Four Thirds system, it is not a problem. It is not something that will make Micro Four Thirds system die. What I don't like about Micro Four Thirds system and the route that they are going in some situation, it is the fact that they are making lenses bigger and bigger and cameras bigger and bigger. I want Micro Four Thirds to be smaller, and especially I want, regarding these image penalties that we have in some lighting situation, I want to have a more accessible price for the Micro Four Thirds camera. So this is what I really don't like at GH6. I think it is very expensive being a Micro Four Thirds camera. Yes, I think it is crazy good. I really love what they've put on that camera. But I really don't like that they stick again with that DFD focus for videography. You need an AF like on Sony cameras, like on Canon cameras and so on. And I really don't like the price and the factor it is big. I get it. It is the flagship camera like Olympus OM-1 that I really like. But now what I hope from Lumix is to take that sensor and to take that and to take those functions and put those functions on smaller cameras. How I've said on my Olympus OM-1 camera, it is important to take all these functions and put them on smaller, more accessible cameras. And Micro Four Thirds system, I will think it will go on, and maybe in time people will be able to appreciate the image quality from a Micro Four Thirds system. You don't take a camera to shoot in night. You don't take a camera to shoot in low light. Good pictures are pictures that are made with good light. This is the basic of photography. You are painting with light. You don't paint without light. You don't paint with darkness. You paint with light. This is the basic concept of photography. Paint with light. So if you know what you are doing, you don't have any complaints regarding the Micro Four Thirds system. It's your fault that the images aren't looking great. It's not the camera and the sensor fault at this moment, at this time. It is your fault that you don't know your camera and that you don't know your light. So this is the problem. I know if you take a full frame camera, you don't have to know light, you don't have to know your camera, because that extra dynamic range and that extra compression resolution and what you get from that full camera will make you escape from your inability to not be able to use the camera. But when you are using a Micro Four Thirds camera, that camera will force you to learn photography. That camera will force you to see light. It's like using a film camera. On film, if you don't use light, you will have a big penalty. You'll waste the film. So I really do love Micro Four Thirds image quality, and I really do think that the problem is not now with that new sensor in the Micro Four Thirds image quality. It is at the user. Yes, you have some limitations, but if you know what you are doing, if you are using pro lenses, you can obtain a very beautiful, dreamy looking image, a very filmish image, a very, I don't know how to say, but a very special look, a very special look that you will not be able to get that look on an APS-C body or on a full frame body. Every system has his own look. The Micro Four Thirds system has its own look, and it is a good look if you are able to understand it and if you are able to use the camera correctly. The APS-C system again has his own look, and full frame system his own look, and medium format system again his own look. And one more stuff that I want to say at the end, it is again, look at those optimized lenses from Panasonic Leica Lumix and Olympus Phaser Bokeh lenses. The lenses are so special. The lenses are so special that f1.2 lenses and f1.4 lenses are so special. You have on Lumix 25mm f1.4 lens a Pana Leica lens. That lens, it is special. That lens, it is special. On Olympus, you have 20mm f1.4 lens, and I really love that lens. It is amazing. Amazing. And I really don't regret buying it, and I really feel it is above and Voigtlander lens. I really think that, I really like that lens for what it is doing. And my advice to you is that you use good lenses, and every time when you don't get the images that you want, don't blame it on the camera system or on your camera. It is you. I'm always doing that. I don't get an image, I don't get a shot, and I'm blaming it on my camera. No, it's not the camera, it's not the lens, it is me. It is always my fault for not being able to get that shot that I wanted. And this doesn't mean just the moment, but also the quality of the shot and so on. If I really would pay attention, if I would really be attentive of what I am doing, if I would really have the right mindset and the right mojo and the right will, and if I will invest the time in that shot, I will really get that shot with every system that I will be able to use at that time. So it's not the system. And I really would love to Micro Four system to go future, because again, I feel that this system, how Robin Wong said, it is the future for the majority of the users. Why? Because the system, it is so versatile that it is able to offering you good videography, good photography, from the normal lenses to the tele lenses. Full frame cameras can do this. APS-C camera can go to the tele lenses that Micro Four Thirds system can, and also to the wide lenses, and also let's think about the image stabilization that you can get from these cameras. So it's up to us to learn the system and to be able to use it to get what we want. And in the end, again, image quality, it's about your own taste. I do feel that every system has its own image quality and I don't criticize another system by referring to another system. You must be able to judge a system for what it is and stop comparing what it is not comparable. I will not compare Monet with a painter that is doing paints like a photography. They are not comparable. So this is why I say stop comparing image quality between systems, because at the end it's depending just on your own taste and your own education to understand that image quality from that system. Again, yes, there are some focal lenses and there are some scenarios where you can compare, but this will be another discussion for another video. So, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel for more content like this and talk to you soon. Bye-bye.